Hello everybody and welcome back, and now let us check the part 2 of the commands that we can run with interpreter shell. So let me just start up my exploit once again. So my listener JZ, then I execute the program and we get the interpreter session opened. So sessions, this is all standard, we already covered how to enter the session, so here we are in the interpreter session. Now, there are a few commands that we can use in order to interact with the system itself. So, for example, this command is very useful if you're, for example, attacking a lower or an older Windows system. What this does is, as it says right here, attempts to elevate your privileges to that of local system. Now, system privileges on Windows are the same as root privileges on Linux. What that means basically is that once you actually get the system privileges, you can say that you fully exploited the machine. As a user, your commands and your basically usage of all the other programs is limited. So in order to do that, you just type here get system. But since this is a Windows 10 machine, the privilege escalation won't really work here. Now, there is another way to do the privilege escalation, which I will show you just in a second after we cover these other commands. So there are some of the commands such as play audio file on target system, nothing written on disk, which is not really that important to us at the moment. What is important for us is, for example, the key logger. If you just type here the command keyscan underscore start, so let us just do that, keyscan underscore start, it will say right here starting the keystroke sniffer, and it will record all of the keystrokes that the target enters in its machine or in its keyboard. So for example, let me just open Notepad right here, and if I just start typing anything in the Notepad, for example hello world and something like that, it will get written to our key logger. So in order for us to print out what the target has typed in its keyboard, we can just type here keyscan underscore dump. And it, as you can see right here, this is the Notepad which I typed in the search bar. So it captured that, and it also captured the hello world, as we can see right here. This shift is referring to the capital letter. That's why it starts right here. So this is useful, for example, if you wanted to capture the passwords once the user logs into the any website, unlike the man in the middle attack where you can only target certain, where you can only target HTTP websites and some HTTPS websites. This will work on any website or basically anything that the target types, since this is a keylogger installed on their local machine. This will capture even if they type it on Facebook or even if they type messages on Messenger, so you can just capture anything basically with this. In order for you to stop the keylogger, once you actually want to end it, you can just type here keyscan underscore stop, and this will stop the keystroke sniffer. So once you type the keyscan dump, it will no longer print the output of the target's keyboard usage. So basically, if you want to, what I usually do is I always at the start turn on the keyscan so I can capture everything that the target types, and then at the end when I want to exit the session, I just basically just dump the keystrokes and close the keylogger. So that is a really useful thing to have. It is installed in interpreter, so you can just type it with one simple command and the keylogger will start. Now I would show you these commands as well, such as webcam chat, webcam snap, but my Windows machine doesn't really have webcam, so I won't be able to do that. What I can show you is, for example, this screenshot right here. This will grab a screenshot of the interactive desktop, which can be also useful. So let me just lower this so you can see. If I just type here in the terminal or in the interpreter terminal screenshot, you will see that it will say screenshot saved to root and then some random name .jpg. Now the screenshot will basically be this screen that you are watching right now, so let us check it out. If we go right here and we lower this screen, do we know that it is saved in root, so we go to places and then computer. Okay, so we go down, scroll to the root, enter right here, and we can see the screenshot really did save right here. So this is also a useful thing to have. Now since we don't need it, I will delete it now. Let me open it in terminal. So open in terminal and remove this. Okay, good. Now let's see if there is anything potentially interested to us as well. So for example, yeah, some of these commands you actually need administrative privileges to run. For example, the clear the event log, you would need to actually have the system privileges in order to perform that. So let us actually see how we can get the system privileges on the Windows 10 machine. Now, first of all, in the Windows XP, for example, and maybe Windows 7, I'm not really sure about that. I'm not really sure about Windows 7. The get system command will work on Windows XP for sure. So just typing this command, you will be able to get the system privileges. But as we can see, that doesn't really work for us. So what we want to do is background this session right here. And the next thing you want to do is basically just search for the bypass module. So the bypass module, you just type here search bypass UAC, and UAC is basically user account control. And you will see these a few different modules that are used in order to bypass the user account control, which will give us hopefully the system privileges on the target machine. Now, if you use the simple one, which is the first one, so you use this one. Let us use it. So use exploit Windows local bypass, and we show our options on it. You will see that it doesn't really work on Windows 10, as if I set here, or let me show targets first, so we can see the available targets. It says right here that it both works on Windows 32-bit and both on Windows 64-bit, but it really doesn't. So let's see if we specify right here the session, which is the only thing that it actually asks from us. So we check the session ID with sessions command. We can see that our session ID is 2, and we set session to 2. And now if we show options once again, we can see that everything is correct. And if I just type here exploit, this won't really work since our target or Windows 10 isn't really vulnerable to this attack. As we can see, exploit aborted due to failure, not vulnerable. Windows 10 is not vulnerable. So what else can we do? If we search bypass once again, so let me just find the command. So here it is. This one will work. I've checked all of these, and the one that works the most, basically this one also works sometimes, but sometimes it just decides not to work. This one works in most of the cases, so exploit Windows local and then bypass underscore fault helper, Windows UX protection bypass. So it came out in 2017 and it is ranked as excellent. So if you just copy this and paste it right here, and we can see that basically I believe it is the same options as in the previous one. So only thing we need to set is the session. So we set the session to 2, since that is the session that we are running on our target Windows 10 machine. And after that, you just click here exploit. Now, the only thing that will happen with this is I believe a PowerShell window will pop up for a brief second, and then it should close. Once it closes, it will open a system meterpreter shell. As we can see, sometimes this happens as well. So it basically just says exploit completed, but no session was created. So what you want to do when it actually completes the exploit, but the session isn't really created and you didn't get the meterpreter shell, you want to run this command until you actually get it. So from a few times, you will be able to get the meterpreter shell. So we run this a second time, and as we can see, we were able to receive the meterpreter shell. There are some of the things that it did. So as we can see, started reverse TCP handler, UETs is enabled, checking level, part of administration group, continuing, and it basically gives us meterpreter shell. So if we background this right now, and I clear our screen a little bit and show my available sessions, you will see that right now we have 2 sessions available. The 2 is the one that we ran with our shell.exe file right here. Let me just close this hello world since we don't need it. This is the 2 session under ID 2, and the session number ID 3 is the one that we got with the bypass fault helper, which we used in order to elevate our privileges. But if you notice right here, we are still not the administrator or the system privilege account on that target PC. We are still this account right here. So what you want to do is go is enter the third session, which is the one that we got with the bypass. And right now, if you just type your get system, the command will simply work, since we were able to bypass the user account control or the UAC. As we can see right here, if I just type here get UID, which will print out who am I, it will say I am authority or system, which is the highest level of privileges you can have on Windows PC. And by this, it means that we fully and successfully exploited the Windows 10 machine. Right now, you can do anything you want to it. You can change even important files, you can crash Windows, you can download, upload. You can basically do anything as well as in with the root privileges in Linux. So if I back around and now type here sessions once again, you will see that one of them is simple user account and the other one is system authority. So in the next video, I will show you how actually you can, if you're running Windows 10 machine, for example, if that's your main host, how you can prevent yourself from this attack. You can prevent anyone from actually bypassing this with File Helper and actually gaining the system privileges to your PC. So that would be about it for this tutorial of privilege escalation and some of the basic commands in Meterpreter, and I hope I see you in the next one, and take care. Bye.